God honors their faith and brings them to the Lord. With these thoughts in mind, listen very carefully to these words. Wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands as unto the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church, and he is the Savior of the body. Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, let the wives be to their own husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for her, that he might sanctify and cleanse it by washing the water by the word, that he might present it to himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be holy and without blemish. So all men ought to love their wives as their own bodies. He that loveth his wife loveth himself. For no man ever yet hateth his own flesh, but nourisheth and cherisheth, even as the Lord the church. We are members of his body, of his flesh, and of his bones. For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall be joined unto his wife, and the two shall be one flesh. This is a great mystery, but I speak concerning Christ and the church. Both the Lord's birth of Paul in Ephesians chapter 5, verses 22-32. Charles, have you accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior? Have you received the Holy Spirit to dwell in you? Yeah. Accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior? Have you received the Holy Spirit to dwell in you? Now, upon the public profession of your faith, you have made known to all men that Jesus Christ of Nazareth is your Lord and Savior. I make this announcement before this congregation and these witnesses. When two people join themselves to the Lord Jesus Christ by faith, according to God's own words, they stand cleansed. As clean God as Adam and Eve were in the Garden of Eden before they sinned. This is not just the forgiveness of sin. The Bible says any man who is in Christ is a new creation. Old things have passed away and all things have become new. A miracle took place when you made Jesus the Lord of your life. The Holy Spirit used the very power of God, his creative power, to cause your spirit to be reborn. It is in the same power God used when he raised Jesus from the dead. You to Jesus by that power. When two born again believers come before God to be joined together as husband and wife, the Apostle Paul calls it a mystery and says, but I speak concerning Christ and the church. When you made Jesus the Lord of your lives, you were joined to him. 1 Corinthians 6:17 says, you are one spirit. Ephesians 5:30 says, you have become one flesh with the Lord. You're his. He is yours. You are one together with him. I want you to understand that if you rightly discern the body of Christ, then you rightly discern the miracle that takes place in marriage. Your spirits will be joined together and you will become one. You will not be one in the eyes of the law only. There is something much more powerful that happens. The very creative power of God will join you together. The same power that joined you with Jesus when you made him Lord. Whatever tamper with that you were, the love of God doesn't say, I love you. Do you really love me? The love of God says very simply, I love you. That's all it ever says. Don't ever tamper with that miracle. Don't ever let the sun go down on your wrath. Something holy, something beyond your reach. It's a precious thing. For the witnesses, I want to speak to you all and say, Jesus said in Matthew 18, shall agree on earth as touching anything that they shall ask, it shall be done for them of my Father which is in heaven. But you're not just here because of tradition. You're here for a serious purpose. Bear witness forever of this miraculous union that will take place in the adoration of God. So don't ever tamper with that agreement. From this day forward, regardless of what comes, you are in agreement with this union. Don't ever attempt in any way to cause it to be anything except a happy union. To the congregation, in the eyes of the Almighty God, these two people are washed in the blood of the Lamb, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. They have prayed, and before God, the Lord God himself, they believe with all their hearts that this is the perfect will of God for them to be joined together. any person who would tamper with it and cause it to be anything other than prosperous in the eyes of God. This is a miraculous thing, and it is of God. Love her even as Christ loves the church, to protect her and care for her the rest of your life. Return to her and make this vision. I, Charles, according to the word of God, leave my mother and my father, and I join myself to you to be a husband to you. From this moment forward, we shall be. Charles, as your husband, submitting yourself to him as unto the Lord, showing reverence to him as the head of the church for the rest of your life. Return to him and make this present. Isaiah, according to the word of God, submit myself to you, to be a wife. From this moment forward, we shall be one. Yeah. One for the Father, one for the Son, one for the Holy Spirit. A ring is a very precious thing, a token of your faith and love. This ring is made from precious material. It's a never-ending circle that indicates the continuum of love that never fails, never presents itself haughtily, nor is it puffed up. The love of God and the faith of God causes His power to move in your lives. Wear these rings as a continual reminder of your faith, continual reminder of your confession of faith that you made to each other and to God. The word of God says, above all, taking the shield of faith, you should be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. Ephesians 6:16. If anyone could break up this union, it would be Satan. He'll give them no place. He'll give them no place. This is forever. Charles, take this ring, these rings, and place them on her finger and say this to her. Blessing of Abraham might come on the Gentiles through Jesus Christ. Blessed shall thou be in the city, and blessed shall thou be in the field. Blessed shall be the fruit of thy body, and the fruit of thy ground, and the fruit of thy cattle, the increase of thy kind, and the flocks of thy sheep. Blessed shall thou be, blessed shall be thy basket in the store. Blessed shall thou be when thou comest in, and blessed shall thou be when thou goest out. The Lord shall cause thine enemies to rise up against thee, and be smitten before thy face. They shall come out against thee one way, and flee before thee seven ways. The Lord shall command the blessing upon thee and thy storehouse, and all that thy set is thy hand. He shall bless thee in the land which the Lord giveth thee. The Lord shall establish thee a holy people unto himself, and he has sworn unto thee, if thou shalt keep the commandments of the Lord thy God, and walk in his ways. And all the people of the earth shall see that thou art called by the name of the Lord. They shall be afraid of thee. And the Lord shall make thee plenteous in goods, in the fruit of thy body, and in the fruit of thy cattle, and in the fruit of thy ground, and in the land which the Lord sware to thy fathers to give. The Lord shall open unto thee his good treasure in heaven to give the rain unto thy land in good season, and to bless all the work of thine hand. And thou shalt lend to many nations, and thou shalt not borrow. And the Lord shall make thee the head and not the tail. And thou shalt be above only, and thou shalt not be beneath. If that thou hurt the commandments, Mrs. Wilson.
Yeah. Amen. Amen. Woo!